flexibility means having some level of choice over how you work. So I think that the overarching theme of flexibility is choice. For a company to score above average, they would have to offer 1 to 2 days a week from home, guaranteed, that is without having to ask. And a little degree of flexibility around hours. So, you know, coming in half an hour later, finishing half an hour later or earlier. That is the kind of minimum flexibility that we would say a truly flexible workplace meets. Companies will come to us believing that they're flexible. But actually what that flexibility means is that they will allow employees to go to the doctor and work from home on that day, or stay in for a package or a delivery, and they think that that means it's flexible. Actually, it's not. That encourages employees to lie.
It's really just about trusting people that they will do the work, and it's more of an outcome-based organization rather than a where you're working from or how you're working.
I'll start with a story. So I left university and went straight into investment banking. I have an autoimmune disease that I've had since I was 18. That means that I'm technically registered as disabled. Anyway, I was there for about 18 months and I asked to work flexibly, to work from home. 1 day a week, you know, nothing groundbreaking, but 5 years ago that was pretty different. And they briefly entertained the idea for 1 week, and then they put a settlement package in front of me, sacked me and told me to leave immediately and never come back. The reason that I asked for it was because I was struggling to maintain a full-time professional career, even though I had the cognitive capacity to do so, just because my feet and my hands were swelling up, and so I couldn't get into an office. It would have meant I wasn't taking sick days, so I would have cost the company less money, and I still would have been able to work to my full capacity and do very well in my career had I just been allowed that. If you trust your employees and you treat them as adults, the likelihood is that 90% of people are going to thrive, and they're going to be very happy that you've been given that autonomy and that freedom to choose how they work. That means that engagement increases, employee retention increases, so they'll stay longer, spending less on recruitment fees as a result of having to replace people, and people are more productive. A flexible work environment is a fundamentally more inclusive working environment. And so companies that offer flexibility are much more likely to be able to build a truly diverse pipeline of people and to get diversity of thought, diversity of experience, and diversity of backgrounds into their company, which often can be a real, real struggle for companies.
Don't look to, you know, for a template of what flexibility is like. Talk to your leaders, talk to your employees, talk to your managers. See what flexibility means for them. Employees know the restrictions that you're working in. So they will, you know, they're going to share with you things that are, you know, practical for your business. And sometimes they'll ask you for something you know, that you can't provide. But go and ask them, first and foremost, what it means to them. And try to ensure to really look at, does that really fit in with who we are as an organization, what we provide, what our product is, and are we able to do something to be more flexible? Push yourselves as an organization, push the boundaries a little bit, and don't expect to kind of have it all nicely tied in a bow before you try something. Because this other piece of advice is, don't expect perfection. Try it out, see how it works. Don't give up on it too quickly, but understand that there are going to be bumpy roads ahead. And with those bumpy roads, you are going to be speaking to your employees, speaking to managers, seeing what works and what doesn't work, and making slight adjustments. But do not give up on it too quickly.
Listening to your employees is the most important place to start. It could be that you make a survey and then take what the majority of people want and start testing that. I think where the biggest issue and hurdle that I see companies facing is they jump to going, oh God, but will we have to pay people's expenses then when they decide to go to the office? And will we have to do at-home risk assessments for working from home? And will we have to provide this and provide that? Cross those bridges when you come to it. It doesn't have to be all in writing at the very beginning. Again, I really think that the best way for companies to approach it is by making that minimum commitment. Don't try and address everything. It's almost impossible.